Hello everybody, welcome to a special spooky edition of Art Whisper 88. When I was a kid, I saw the painting of Paul Klee called Letter Ghost. And even as a child, I thought that image was pretty scary because it was very mysterious. And it didn't look like any kind of paintings that I had seen before. So I'm going to use that as an inspiration piece for this spooky season of Halloween. And on your screen, I had drawn out with my Sharpie pen some skull shapes, which are similar to the spooky image of Paul Klee. So I'm going to use these. This, by the way, is Bristol card, which is nice and firm and will stand up as a stencil. Okay, I have my skull shapes, and I found some of these old stencils, which they do look like masks, especially this one. So I'm going to combine these shapes and come up with something. So I'll be right back. Don't go away. Okay, here we are at the next portion of this video. I'm going to use my Posca marker and make some basic shapes. Now I will use, this is Basics acrylic fluid. I'm going to use this as the foundation layer. It's a little bit watery, so it's very different from the heavier, the regular. It's a little more watery than this. This is the studio acrylic, and it has a heavier body. So I'm going to combine the two. Now, since the fluid acrylic is more watery, it forms this kind of lacy pattern, which I don't mind. It adds to the texture in this piece. Now, it's supposed to be a spooky piece, so I'm using the heel of my brayer to make some lines. Okay. Now I have gone back to using my favorite Somerset paper. Which I find very pleasant to use. It's thick enough, but not too stiff. And it has a very beautiful, flexible nature because it's 100% cotton. Okay, so since I'm trying to pick up the three ghost elements here, I would leave this for 5 minutes. Okay, it's been about 5 minutes. Let's see what we got. Almost like a parchment kind of texture. Okay, I like that. It's pretty spooky already. Now, this is a little dry here, but I can remedy that with the next layer. So I will air dry this piece and then arrange my second layer of stencils. Okay, my next layer will be a combination of ultramarine and light blue. Now this is Blickcrylic, by the way. So here's the first layer. Okay, since the paint is laid on very heavily, I'm not going to wait too long. Cool. It kind of solved the problem on the left side. Let me see if I can capture this. Again, I will leave this for 5 minutes. Okay, let's see what we have here. I think it's a very nice transfer. It's a little somber because of the black, but it is spooky looking. Check this out. So I will air dry this piece. I'll air dry both pieces because the paint application is on the heavy side, and I will be back when they're dry. So don't go away. Okay, here we are at the next step. And I've laid down my little skulls. And I will be using, this is carmine red for the center portion. And then just to add a little sparkle, here's some metallic copper. This time I will be rolling in a horizontal direction. So here is the first piece. Okay, let's see what we got. Pretty cool. Now let's see if I can capture this on the second piece. So I think the colors will work on both pieces. Very cool. I love this. The ghost print always wins. So I will air dry both pieces and then decide what the next step will be. Okay, I think this needs a little spooky collage. So, now, since this is white tissue paper, I'm hoping that it will show what's underneath. Because once it's mounted, usually it becomes transparent. Okay, that's it for the first piece. There. I like that. So I'll put this under a desk fan and recap. Okay, here's my favorite part of this video, where I get to show you the finished piece. And here is a close-up. Now you can barely see the skulls, but they are lurking behind the stencils. Thank you. That's the first print. Here's the second one. Usually the ghost print always looks better. I think the colors blend much better. They're more subtle. There seems to be more information visually. Just put this to one side and put the inspiration piece next to it. I hope you like this Halloween video. I had a lot of fun making these. It's a little different from what I usually do, just a little whimsical diversion. And thank you so much for watching and for subscribing, and for all those who gave support to my PayPal, thank you so much. Thank you so much for all you wonderful viewers and buyers who have purchased my work. And I want to wish everyone a happy Halloween. I will see you next time.